Is it about statues and monuments? I know saw the interview I did with Cory Stewart, mm-hmm. who's trying to run for a Senate seat there in Virginia, and he makes the case that it is about statues and monuments, and everyone's trying to make it about something else.
I think that we have to get to the heart of the problem here, and the heart of the problem is the way in which many of us were taught American history. American history is not all glorious, and even though I love John to death, I couldn't disagree more about George Washington. George Washington was a slave owner, and we need to call slave owners out for what they are. Whether we think they were protecting American freedom or not, he wasn't protecting my freedom. I wasn't someone who my ancestors weren't deemed human beings to him. And so to me, I don't care if it's a George Washington statue or a Thomas Jefferson statue or a Robert E. Lee statue. They all need to come down. There is a way that we can recognize and appreciate. I'm going to finish my point. I'm not feeding into white supremacy. I'm calling out white supremacy for what it is. And sometimes what it is, John, are blind spots. Sometimes what it is not acknowledging that this country was built upon a very violent past that resulted in death and the raping and the killing of my ancestors. So I'm not going to allow us to say that it's okay for a Robert E. Lee, but not a George Washington. We need to call it what it is. And I'm not saying that they don't deserve to be taught about. We definitely need to learn about it so that we don't repeat it, because we're very close to repeating it right now. But I'm not giving any deference to George Washington or to Robert E. Lee.
Well, let me jump
Hang
in
on,
with
right. Go, okay. go ahead, John.
Look, we got to be real careful here, because what we're doing here is polarizing the conversation exactly in the direction that Donald Trump wants, Angela. Yep. We can obviously, the founding fathers were slave owners, but the